गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, माई सेल्फ नेम पी एस तिवारी फ्रॉम एल पी सवानी विद्या भवन। वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द सब्जेक्ट ओसी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ कॉमर्स। लेट्स स्टार्ट। यस चिल्ड्रन, सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस चैप्टर नंबर 3, दैट इज़ प्लानिंग। दिस चैप्टर इज़ फॉर 7 मार्क्स इन योर बोर्ड एग्जामिनेशन। नाउ रिफ्लेक्टेड थिंग्स एट द ग्लांस पॉइंट, रिफ्लेक्टेड पॉइंट विल आस्क फॉर 5 मार्क्स इन योर बोर्ड एग्जामिनेशन। दैट इज प्रोसेस ऑफ प्लानिंग, टाइप्स ऑफ प्लानिंग एंड एलिमेंट्स ऑफ प्लानिंग। एनी वन क्वेश्चन विल कम इन योर एग्जाम फॉर 5 मार्क्स। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द सेम इन डिटेल। यस चिल्ड्रन, यू कैन सी ऑन योर स्क्रीन द प्रोसेस ऑफ प्लानिंग, दैट इज डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ ऑब्जेक्टिव। चिल्ड्रन, ऑलवेज व्हाइल यू आर स्टार्टिंग अप द प्रोसेस एंड स्टेजेस ऑफ प्लानिंग, ऑलवेज स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द बॉटम लेवल एंड मूव टूवर्ड अपवर्ड डिरेक्शन। फाइन, दैट मीन्स व्हाइल यू आर स्टार्टिंग अप द बिजनेस, ऑलवेज यू आर ट्राइंग टू स्टेज अप टूवर्ड्स द फॉरवर्ड। सो द फर्स्ट पॉइंट विल कम एट द बॉटम एंड द लास्ट पॉइंट विल कम एट द टॉप। सो हियर इज द स्टेजेस, दैट इज प्रोसेस ऑफ प्लानिंग। फर्स्ट, डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ ऑब्जेक्टिव। सेकेंड, क्लियरिफिकेशन, प्लानिंग प्रिमाइसिस। थर्ड, कलेक्शन एंड अनालिसिस ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन। फोर्थ, प्रिपरेशन ऑफ अल्टरनेटिव प्लान। फिफ्थ, इवेल्युएशन ऑफ अल्टरनेटिव्स। सिक्स्थ, सिलेक्शन ऑफ बेस्ट अल्टरनेटिव्स। सेवेंथ, फॉर्मुलेशन एंड इवेल्युएशन ऑफ सब्सिडरी प्लान। एंड द लास्ट इज इवेल्युएशन ऑफ प्लान। सो चिल्ड्रन, दिस वी विल स्टडी इन डिटेल। यस चिल्ड्रन, नाउ यू कैन सी द फर्स्ट एंड सेकेंड पॉइंट ऑन योर स्क्रीन। फर्स्ट इज डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ ऑब्जेक्टिव। द फर्स्ट स्टेप ऑफ प्लानिंग इज सेटिंग द ऑब्जेक्टिव। That means while you are doing, while you want to start up the business, the first thing will come in your mind is what is your objective. It should be proper manner. You should be clear about the objective. I have to achieve this. That means you should be proper mannered, the determination of objective. Then planning becomes useful to the management. You know that managerial function post-COP. P is for planning, and because of planning we can run the other managerial function, that is directing, staffing, coordinating, controlling, etc. That means planning becomes useful to the management. This is, without this we can't run the other managerial function. Then it should be pragmatic, that means practical. Whatever planning you are doing, that not be a illusion. It should be a pragmatic, that is practical one. Whatever you are planning, whatever is your objective which you are determining, it should be pragmatic, it should be practical. Then the second one is clarifying planning premises. This premises means assumption or forecasting. This premises means assumption or forecasting. Forecasting should be considered after internal and external factor affecting business unit. While you are clarifying the planning premises, over there you should be clear about the assumption and forecasting. And while you are forecast anything, while you are analyzing something, over there you should be aware about the internal and external factor which may affect the business unit, and that is your limitation even. So while you are determining the objective, your planning premises should be clear. Yes children, now you can see on your screen third, fourth, fifth point. Third, collection and analysis of information. Collection and analysis of information is all about information collected either directly or indirectly. Whatever information you want to start up your business, it should be either डायरेक्ट वे और इनडायरेक्ट वे. इट हेल्प्स टू मेक अजम्पशन टू गेट द एक्सपेक्टेड रिजल्ट इन फ्यूचर. वट एवर इंफॉर्मेशन यू आर कलेक्टिंग एनालाइजिंग दैट विल बी हेल्पफुल इन योर फ्यूचर टारगेट एंड ईजिली यू कैन अचीव द सेम. दैट मीन्स द कलेक्शन ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन वट एवर इंफॉर्मेशन यू आर कलेक्टिंग इट शुड बी प्रिसाइज एंड द इंफॉर्मेशन वट एवर यू हैव कलेक्टेड दैट यू आर सपोज टू अनालाइज. आफ्टर अनालिसिस इट विल बी इम्प्लीमेंट. सो द कलेक्शन ऑफ द पास्ट इंफॉर्मेशन एंड द अनालिसिस ऑफ द सेम हाउ मच इज इट इज़ करेक्ट एंड हाउ मच इट इज इनकरेक्ट दैट अनालिसिस शुड बी done by you guys. So the collection and analysis of information is considered under the process of planning. Fourth, preparation of alternative plan. After above three process, interpretation is must. After above three process, that means determination of objective, clarifying the planning, collection and analysis of information, all this has to be done or interpret in fourth one. But thus a list of alternative has to be made. Why you are preparing the list of alternative? Meanwhile, whatever you have made the plan, always you are making more than three plan, always you are making more than three plan. That means our alternative option should be available in front of us. That is, according to the characteristic of planning, list of alternative must, then only according to the time, situation and circumstances, you can switch your plan. You can switch your plan. Then, fifth one, evaluation of alternative. Evaluation, it's examine. Examine of alternative means you can see the green highlighted work, that is operation research. You are examining your alternative, which is suitable for your business and which is not. That operation you should be do. Content, mathematical and statistical method are used for the evaluation of alternatives. Mathematical and statistical method you are accepting for the evaluation of alternative. That is why business unit prepare an ideal plan as a model with the help of operation research. That means business unit always prepare an ideal plan for moduling with the help of operation research, with the help of operation, with the help of evaluation, with the help of examination. You can do the alternative evaluation. Fine? Yes, children. Now you can see the other three option, that is 6th, 7th, 8th, 6th, selection of best alternative, 7th, formulation and evaluation of subsidiary plan, and the last is evaluation of plan. 6th, after evaluation of all available alternative, best one is selected. You are making a list of alternative. You have evaluated the same with the help of mathematical and statistical tool, then you will select the best alternative which is present in front of you, the best one which is suitable for your business, you will select the same. Then the 7th one, formulation and evaluation of subsidiary plan. Preparation of additional plan with basic plan is called subsidiary plan. Preparation of additional plan with basic plan is called subsidiary plan. That means additional plan what you are doing. So for example, a vehicle manufacturer company is decided to make or buy tire, to make or buy tires. That means to make is the basic plan and subsidiary plan is buy tires, buy tires. Fine. So whenever you are starting up the business, after the evaluation of all the internet alternatives, you are selecting the best alternative, then you should formulate and evaluate the subsidiary plan, the additional plan which is related with your product. Then the 8th one, evaluation of plan. Business unit takes help from expert and consultant to evaluate the plan. business unit takes help from expert and consultant to evaluate the plan. At every stage, evaluation is necessary. All stage evaluation must. When we proceed step by step, the principle of look and live is to be adopted. Whenever you are proceeding step by step, the principle of look and live is to be adopted. Evaluation, examine has been done by experts and consultant with their experience. Evaluation must go on for every stages, and this stages, the examination of all the stages is called look and live method. So children, we have done with the process of planning with their A stages, and this stage you can write down like same diagram you can reflect in your exam, which will help you to get full marks in your exam. Yes children, here you can see the types of planning. Actually there are 6 types of planning: standing plan, strategic plan, single use plan, tactical plan, operational plan, contingency plan. Repeating: standing plan, strategic plan, single use plan, tactical plan, operational plan and contingency plan. These are the types of planning. Let's see this answer in detail. Yes children, now you can see on your screen 3 types of planning, that is standing plan, strategic plan and single use plan. First one, standing plan represent guideline for decision. Standing plan is all about, we are representing the guideline for decision. Standing plan can be used repeatedly. Standing plan repeatedly you can use in your business. Policy, methods and rules made for long-term process. Whatever policy, method and rules you are making, that will be useful for long-term. It helps the subordinates to take prompt decision. No employee will need the permission of supervisor. This is called standing plan. The last point will ask in your 1 mark answer, in which no employee will need the permission of supervisor, over there you should reflect standing plan. Then second one, strategic plan. Decide the objective according to philosophy. Long-term and short-term strategy are decided. Inside this, long-term or short-term strategy are decided. In above, only long-term process are there. Then the third point, it will consider its strength and drawbacks. Under strategic plan, you are looking after the strength and drawbacks. So if you know about your drawbacks, so shortly you can make your strategy, you know about your strength. For long term, you can make your strategy. In case in between need any change, you can. Fine. So strategic plan is more comfortable as compared with the standing plan, because it is the objective according to philosophy, useful for long term and short term strategy. It will consider your strength and drawbacks. Then third one, single use plan means while one time plan applied. Single use plan means one time applied activity which do not recur. Activity which you are not supposed to recur, that means change, recycle. You are not supposed to change the same. Once you have applied, you have to follow the same. Which are the plan? Making house, packaging, printing, etc. This will considered for long term process. One time you have applied, you are not supposed to recur in between. This is for long term planning, not short term. So by taking a full time, you can do this, that is single use plan, which in between you are not supposed to change. Example, house, packaging, printing, etc. Yes children, here are the other 3 plan that is tactical, operational and contingency. Tactical plan prepared by middle level of management. Children, fourth one and fifth one is similar. Fine. Fourth one, prepared by middle level of management. Tactical plan is prepared by the middle level of management. This follows the short-term plan. This follows the short-term plan. That means the middle level of management are not having authority to take the decision for long-term process. So directly you can correlate middle level of management are having authority to take short-term plan. Third, short-term duration means usually span 1 year or less. Short-term means what? 1 year or less than. Specialized knowledge and skills are necessary. Middle level of management, they are specialized in their category, that means finance, production, purchase, sale, etc. They are experts in their special category. In the special category, they are having the special knowledge and skill which is necessary. So these are the four content related with the tactical plan. Now operational plan. Use for production. Operational plan, this is useful for production. Operational plan are specific result, expected plan. Operational plan you are taking for specific result expected. Then experimental based planning, experiment, operation, operation, experiment, correlate. Fine. Operational plan is called experimental based plan. Above content follows short duration, that means 1 year. Operational plan following for 1 year. This is short term plan, but still like 1 year. Tactical plan 1 year or less. Operational plan 1 year for short duration. They are experimenting. Operational plan is almost similar to tactical plan. As I have said, operational plan is similar to tactical plan because this is also made by the middle level of management. Short term duration, that means 1 year. Special results should be maintained for future orientation. And we can say that this is an experimental base. Fine, almost operational plan and tactical plan is correlate with each other, similar with each other. Sixth one, contingency plan. At the time of emergency, contingency, emergency, emergency, contingency. That means at the time of emergency, you are switching up your plan. Every situation like changing in political, economical, social or natural factor. If you are facing any of the problem in your business, that is called emergency situation. At that point, you are following the contingency plan. For emergency plan, if changes made in original plan or new plan because of situation is called contingency plan. If you are doing some changes in your original plan and you are formulating some new plan because of the situation, that is called contingency plan, emergency plan. Because of the situation you are changing and you are accepting a new plan because of emergency. So you can say that this is your contingency plan. So children, we have done with the types of planning: standing plan, strategic plan, tactical plan, operational plan, single use plan and contingency plan. Yes, now on your screen you can look after elements, components of planning. Components of planning: objective, strategy, method, procedure, policy, program, rules, budget. This is your element, that is component of planning, by which you can accomplish your goal. Objective, strategy, method, procedure, policy, program, rules and budget. Let's see this answer in detail. Yes, this is your answer for point 1, 2, 3 and 4. Objective, strategy, method and procedure. First one, objective. Determine and fulfill objective. Objective must be pragmatic, that is practical. This you can write down from your process also. Determination of objective and here is the objective. Both point you can write. Determine and fulfill the objective. Objective must be pragmatic, that is practical. Second one, strategy. Pre-decided objective of planning are known as strategy. Exactly, strategy means planning only. So pre-decided objective of planning, whatever you are pre-deciding what you want to do in planning is called your strategy. Business unit capable enough to face the competition against a factor affecting. Business unit are enough capable to face the competition against the factor of affecting. It should be confidential. Ideal strategy gives guarantee of success. Ideal strategy gives the guarantee of success. Third one, method. Method is an arrangement for carrying out business program. Method is an arrangement for carrying out the business program. Method you are accepting. This is called your arrangement of business program. Fourth, procedure. Policy is all about procedure. Policy means procedure. Refer to the best way. Procedure you are referring to the best way. Fulfill the objective by policy and procedure. Fulfill the objective, whatever is your objective, that you can fulfill with the help of policy and procedure. Then fifth one, then here you can see the other points, that is 5th, 6th, 7th, and 8th. Policy, program, rules, budget. Policy, decision and strategy are decided by management for accomplishment of objective is known as policy. Whatever strategy you are making for discipline, for taking decision, is called policy. It gives an idea of efficiency and working style. With the help of policy, you can come to know that what is the efficiency of your worker and what is your work style. That is called policy. Sixth one, program. Program is a sequence of activity. Program, that means a sequence of activity which you are doing. Problem does not arise in program if you are following some of the program which sequentially you are following according to the same you are following the activity. That means you are not supposed to face any problem in between. Take corrective step if any deviation is found. You can see if any changes, deviation, that means changes, if you can see any changes, so correct decision should be taken with the help of program. Then rules. Rules are necessary, but obvious rules are necessary. It decided procedure and gives the clear understanding. Rules is helpful for deciding the procedure and it will give the clear understanding. It ensures the discipline. Rules, while we are making some of the rules in any of the game, it will reflect and give the ensure. That means we are supposed to follow the discipline. Assurity of discipline can be reflected with the help of rules. Then budget. Budget is used as a tool of control. Budget is used as a tool of control. If I know my budget is this much, so I will plan accordingly. That is why element and component of planning is includes budget. With the help of budget, I can come to know that how much plan I have to prepare and in which direction I have to spend. All the expenditure comes under the budget. That is why budget is considered as an element or component of planning. Types of budget. Which type of budget are there? Capital expenditure budget, sales budget, production cost budget, cash budget, etc. These type of budgets are there by which we can use the budget procedure and it will helpful as a element of planning. Yes, student. So in today's lecture, we have done with the process of planning, types of planning, elements and component of planning. And all this question separately, all this question is most important for 5 marks. And from this chapter, again repeating, 5 marks question will come in your exam. So be prepared. And for 5 marks question, kindly refer these 3 question: process, types and element of planning. Yes, children, we have done with the chapter planning, which is for 7 marks. Thank you for the day. And if you have any query related with the videos, any of the content in online session, we'll discuss the same. Thank you for the day.